All right. So I shared this folder with you. Anytime you make a slide deck for a new lesson, you're just going to right click on template small and hit make a copy. Okay. When you make a copy, the title of it will just be like copy of template small. And so then you could just like open this up and change the title. Like in this case, like lesson four, and then whatever the topic is. And then you'd go through and just adjust all these. If you wanted to take slides like this out, you totally can. What I'm hoping for is just like a variety, you know, of different styles. But then just filling them in with the course content. So let me go ahead and show you. Let's see if we've made that change. Yeah, it did. All right. So I'm going to delete this. Remove. And let me show you what I've done with the first couple. Okay, I've done the first three lessons, and there are 13 lessons. So there are 11 left. Oh, it's already open. All right. So here's what we got. With the class, the way that it is, hang on a sec. Yeah, so with the class, the way that it is, let me open up our class here. So I'm going to send you a link.
Okay.
This one, then that one. All right. So this right here, and I'll just send you an email real quick. Link. Okay, so that's just one of the assignments. But you can look like right here, if I take this proof off, this will take me to lesson one, and I can click to all of the different activities in here. So let me actually send you that link.
Okay.
And then I can just like change this to like lesson two, and I can see what the reading is going to be, what the different assignments are going to be. And so you're going to start with lesson four.
Okay.
Okay. And I'm going to make some notes for you in here while we're talking. But the content that I want you to use when you're making the slideshow should primarily come from the prepare reading material. So most content will come from prepare reading material. But then I want you to look at checkpoint, team activity, improve, and include any information that would help students on these assignments. Okay, so if the reading material doesn't cover like some function that you feel like could be helpful for them, feel free to put it into the slides.
Okay.
These slides are meant to help them, you know, to learn so that they can actually do their work. But first and foremost, it'll cover most of the stuff in the reading, and because generally the stuff in the reading should prepare them for their assignments. Should. But yeah, does that make sense?
Okay. Yeah. Sure.
Okay. So let's head back over here. Let's look at a couple of things. So notice, I'm going to go over to lesson two. It's more of a normal lesson. The lesson one isn't the best example because I'm also introducing the course, the entire course.
Okay.
But you can look at lesson two and lesson three as examples.
Yeah, sure.
But notice that I put the title of the module right here. If I look back at the course module, the course content right here, it would be solving problems using variables and expressions. Okay.
Yeah.
Title. We have lesson four, solving problems with variables and expressions. And then I put this into every single one of them. So these links right here, if I copy that it's just straight to that GitHub pages. Okay, so we have lesson two checkpoint. Okay, and it'll just go directly here. Okay, they don't touch PyLearn at all. And so for each slide show that you do, include this slide, everything to this lesson.
Okay.
And then just change these. So like for four, you just say 04 prepare checkpoint, 04 teach, 04 prove, 04 ponder. And then any of them that have links to the GitHub pages like this, like I could go to like 04 checkpoint and here it is. Any of them that have links, go ahead and put those links into here. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Then we keep going. Kahoots, you don't really have to worry about those. If I want to add them later, I can. I mainly want you to worry about getting all the course content from the reading and then checkpoint team and prove activities into here. So moving right along. So like this, if I look at the week two prepare, let me show you this real quick. This table is in there. Okay.
Yeah.
So like I recreated this table in here and I used it to teach. And then I was like, you know what? I'm going to put this link here to show them a lot more string functions that exist that they didn't even see, you know, and I didn't spend very much time on this slide, but it's here, you know? So I used like the course material here and I just kind of like went through and included things that they would need to know and that I felt would help them. Then after that, I did a couple of examples, you know? So one of the parts in the reading, if I come down here, right here. All right, so you might have to watch these videos to see what is in them and what we should include in the slides. But there were a couple of videos on how to format strings. And so I went ahead and I wrote up a little bit of code in VS Code just to show them how we can do that. All right. Any questions up to this point?
No, I think I got it.
Okay, cool. So anyways, I keep going. At the end of every one, I like to have a piece of code that kind of like reviews everything that we've gone through. And so I'll ask you to write that, you know, so if you have stuff talking about naming variables or using input or formatting strings, go ahead and write some code. Like this one's only 11 lines long. It's not very long, but this is pretty much everything we talked about, you know. I tried to use like the capitalized function and the upper function and title and camel. And yeah, I showed them like 10 different functions, but I got four in there, you know? And so this slide is kind of meant to just be like a review for them. And then if you could write up that code and just send it to me, or actually better yet, you could just put the code in here. So when you make a lecture, it's like for lecture four, you could just say like lesson four, the title, and then upload a Python file here too that says lesson four review.py or something.
Okay.
So that I can have that. Okay, let's keep going. After that, I have an activity. It's usually really simple. Usually we don't have very much time at the end of the class, but all of them are pretty simple. I just say that we're going to do random breakout rooms, have somebody lead and share their screen, and then together write a program, use three of the new functions that we haven't used before. You know, really simple. And then you can see the same thing if I open up three. I actually think I copied three from two and then I just took stuff out. It's like, I'm gonna have the title page. I'm gonna have this page. I just have to change the links and change these to like 04. I'm gonna have this question slide. But yeah, they're really similar. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So one thing that I haven't talked to you about, so we've kind of talked about style. Again, I don't care what order these slides are in. They all look a little different as far as like the theme of the slides. I just want there to be variety. You know, I don't really care what you use. But one thing that I wanted to show you, look at this. So I'm going to hit present right here. And notice there's nothing here. Have you ever made a slideshow before?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So I just animated each one of these.
Yeah.
All right. And so when I click, it'll just fill in these different things. Now, this looks fancy, but all it is a couple of pictures.
Yeah.
That I took. Just a couple of screenshots that were smaller and larger screenshots. But anyways, so with slides, with content like that, go ahead and use animations to animate stuff. To do that, it's really simple. I think I did a lot of them in lesson three. Like right here, if I hit present, I haven't done it yet. Well, let's go ahead and do this one actually. So I started working on three. It doesn't look like I've finished it. Like I don't have my review slide in here yet. Okay. But if I wanted to animate something in here, so like I might want to animate all of this at the same time. Okay, I'd probably want all that to show up at once. I would hit animate, and then it pops up over here. It shows those three things that I selected, and they're going to fade in on click. Okay, it shows right here that it'll go on click, and then these other two will go with it. All right, and so then I'd click on this one, and we'll animate that one next. Okay, and then I'll do these three, animate those next, and then this one I'll animate. And by default, it'll just be on click, fade in on click. Then I'll do these ones, add animation, the description, and this would be the last, whoops. This would be the last one, add animation and add animation. Okay, now if I hit play, I can see what it'll look like and make sure that everything looks good. So I click once, it pops up those three, click again, click, 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 click. Okay.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I understood this. I want just to ask about that piece of code. How did you do that animation? Was that like a lot of screenshots or?
Yeah. So let me actually show you what that looks like.
Yeah. This one.
You see that?
Oh, gotcha. Gotcha. Yeah.
Screenshot, okay. One last line of code.
Yeah.
Which is a bit cumbersome to do. I have a program right here. Let me show you. It's around here somewhere. Maybe, probably some. Yeah, so something like this. And what I did was I drew a shape, and I said the fill was the same color as this, and then I drew a big old rectangle, and then I copied this image, and then I came in here. And I shrunk that down, and then I copied this image.
Okay,
good. And I copied this image. Snagit, this program I paid for. But the other option is you can just put the code in here. It doesn't even have to be a screenshot. You know, if it doesn't work out like this, you could even just send me the code and just put each line of code in here. So like if I was going to make a new one, I could even just type it in here. I'd say name equals input. Please enter your name. You know, and just kind of, got to watch out for that. To capitalize that. It does that like every time. Drives me nuts. But anyways, if I wanted to animate something like this, I could say print name and print hello world, whatever code there is. What I can do is when I go to animate this, I can just click on the box and hit animate. And then right here, I click on by paragraph. Okay. And then if I go to play animation, I'll have to click for each paragraph in here.
Okay.
Cool. Okay. So that's one option. So if you want to do that and send me the code, I can just copy the code into my text editor, take a screenshot and do that.
Okay.
Or if you want to try it, there are some good free programs out there. Let me see. Pick is one of them. Yeah. And I think it's free. I used to use this, actually. Yeah. So maybe try this one. Because I think you'll be able to do exactly what I just did with it.
Okay.
So I'll put this in your email that I'm writing to you. So, good program for screenshots. Okay. All right. What other questions do you have?
I think that's it. I think I got it. And also for the grading. So do you want me to assist you in the grading or something like that?
Right now, I'm going to have you focused on the slides.
Okay.
That's all I'm going to have you do. So this course, I don't know if you knew this, but I'm teaching 110 on the block, which means...
Yeah, I saw it.
Yeah, yeah. So so they're doing like 2 weeks every week, you know? So yeah. That lesson four that I'm asking you to do, I have to teach next week on Wednesday. And so I'm just going to have you focus on the slides right now until we finish all the slides and they all look good. And then I'll find more work for you.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Okay. Any other questions for me? Are you good?
Yeah, I feel comfortable with this. So
okay.
I don't have any questions.
Okay. Awesome. Well, this has been shared with you. I'll go ahead and just put this link in here just for kicks.
Okay.
Okay. And you should have access to that. So,
yeah.
Okay. And then anytime you finish one, just let me know.
Yeah.
And I'll go and look at it and adjust any little things if needed. And yeah, we'll go from there.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thanks, Mateo. Good luck.
Yep. Have a good day. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.